Now we will go to the internal of Mason's alone. So in order to understand that, you should go to the what? This is the midbrain cross. So this will be the what? Where you can feel the midbrain. You should have one transverse cut at the what? Superior colliculus and the inferior colliculus, which are there of the part of tectum. So we have to go first internal of midbrain at inferior colliculus. So this is first at this point. So what are the things are there in that? So first you will be having the nucleus of inferior colliculus. Inferior nucleus. Inferior nucleus of colliculus. Second, fifth cranial nerve, that is trigeminal nerve, Mason's hypotalamic. Third, lateral meniscus. Then medial laminiscus. Then temporofontine. Spinal and corticonuclear tracts. Then third cranial nerve, that is oculomotor. Then fontofontine tracts. Then you have got the crura cerebri. Then the depreciation of superior cerebellar parenchyma. Posterior perforating substance. Substantia nigra. Superior cerebellar most important value. Important. Then 15th, medial longitudinal fibers. Then cerebral aqueduct, or sac of Fabius. So these will be there at inferior follicular surface. Now we have the growth of the water. Superior follicles. So what are all the internals? First you will be having inferior brachium, nucleus. Second, medial meniscus. Third, you will be going to get what is said to be as a temporal pontine fibers. Fourth, corticospinal and cortico nuclear tracts with nucleus, frontopontine, tract, third cranial nerve nucleus. That is oculomotor. Then seventh, crura cerebri. Posterior perforating substance. Then you will be having mammillary body, which is the part of hypothalamus. Interpeduncular fossa. Interpeduncular fibers. In fossa. Then you will be going to get from the, that is the 12th, means here 11th, you will be having substantia nigra. Well, going to get the what, third cranial nerve nucleus. Third cranial nerve nucleus. Apart from that, you will be having at the level of superior follicular lateral ventilated body. Body which is the part of metathalamus. Then you will be having next internal reticular formation. Which is the most important. It will be there at the what, medulla, at the pons, and at the what, midbrain. Then pre-aqueductal gray matter. Then you have what, superior folliculus. Superior folliculus. Then last, cerebral aqueduct. So it will be the thing that what you will be going to get into the part. Now after having had this, these are all the things which are present in the water, that of the internal of the internal of. Hello, namaskar. Couple of England. Ek aadha ghanta mein nikalta hoon. Now we have to go to the water. These are all the things that what you will be going to get into the internal of the water, that of the, you can say, midbrain, where these all nucleuses are present, and these nucleuses which are there, they will be going to spread into the water, different parts in which the neurons are there. Neuronal geographical distributions are there. So that is what. Now we will go to the what, another part. That is what is said to be the connections present in the water, that of the midbrain. Connections in the midbrain. Now the connections when we have taken. Now these connections. Number one, the fibers are connecting to the what, midbrain, to the other part, and the other subdivisions of the what, that of the brain. Now here, fifth cranial nerve nucleus, fifth cranial nerve fibers, fourth cranial nerve fibers, third cranial nerve fibers. Then frontofontine fibers or tracts, temporofontine fibers, parietofontine fibers. Parieto-occipital fibers, transverse peduncular particle fiber. Medial longitudinal fasciculus. Fasciculus. Rugrospinal tract. Then you will be having the afferent tracts. Afferent tracts from globus pallidus substantia nigra hypothalamus. Subthalamicus, and the spinal cord. These are the afferent tracts. Afferent tracts. And you will be having this different tract. 16th pectobulbar tract. Tegmentospinal tract. Tectospinal tract, medial vestibular tract, medial vestibular spinal tract, then you have got external corticopectal tract, external corticopectal tract, then tectotegmental tract, tectotegmental tract. Now these are all the tracts that which will be there in the water, that of the midbrain. So via this, it will be connecting to the water, other parts of the water, that of the brain. So this is the thing. Applied anatomy of this, if any damage by means of the water, that of the, you can say, over the midbrain, internal, that is the nucleus and the fibers, it will be not able to perform the normal physiological activities. So that will be the thing what it will be going to brought into an action. The cause for that, it may be traumatic, or it may be the water, that of the vascular event. Vascular event, clot will be there. Because of clot, there will be a pressure over the water, that of the, you can say, midbrain, and then the part of that thing will be going to press neuron structures, and then unable to get the function. So this is what you will be getting. Thank you with this patiently listening.